And listen, while we do know some of the facts about today's crash, there are also many unanswered questions. Seth Kovar continues our team coverage tonight. He is live at NAS Kingsville with more on what happened this morning. The best news, of course, Seth, is that everyone is walked away and is okay.
Yeah, that is the best news possible, Katya. A Navy leader tells me that both training jets that were involved in today's mid-air collision, well, they were doing some formation training when they bumped into each other. One of those planes, though, was actually able to make it here to Naval Air Station Kingsville safely and come in for a perfect landing. Here's what happened to the other crew in some exclusive video you'll see only on Chris 6 News. The student pilot and the instructor had to eject before their plane crashed. They both went to Christus Spahn Hospital Clayburg, but they've already been treated and released. Thankfully, they were not hurt badly. Here's a look at the scene near the crash sites. This is as close as we could get to where the training jet went down. A man who lives about a mile and a half away is used to loud Navy training jets doing their training, but today was different. He heard an explosion, then he looked back and saw what he thought looked like a mushroom cloud. Now, you have heard that a lot of agencies are looking into this crash, no doubt. It's worth repeating, though, if you do happen to find yourself in this area, you find some debris from a plane crash, don't touch it. Instead, report it. We have the phone number you need to call on our website. That's ChrisTV.com. Reporting live in Kingsville, Seth Kovar, Chris 6 News.
All right, thank you for that, Seth. And as we mentioned earlier, this is the second Navy training flight crash in less than 2 months. That other crash happened on March 24th near Orange Grove. That crash involved a T-45 training jet that also flew out of NAS Kingsville. Two pilots were on board that training jet when it crashed. Both were able to also eject safely. They were treated also for minor injuries. The cause of that Orange Grove crash is still under investigation. And as you just heard, today's crash and the one back in March both involved T-45 Goshawk jets. Here's some facts that you may not know about that trainer jet. It is considered the backbone of flight training at Naval Air Station Kingsville. The T-45 has been the primary trainer for Navy and Marine pilots since 1992. 50% of Navy and Marine Corps jet pilots come out of NAS Kingsville. Each year, 200 flight students report to NAS Kingsville for jet training. That training period runs from 11 to 12 months.